浩浩放学了，哎，小小怎么跟你一起回来呀？
小小请假了，
请假了。
开门，
开门，
趁我们发火之前，你赶紧给我开门，你别动我。浩浩，
看什么呢？浩浩，快来洗手吃饭。
开门，
快点。
我跟你好好说话，你赶紧往出走。
先洗个热水澡。
我不小心把鞋都弄地上了，我现在就擦，很快的。起来。
别！我今天光说了，真的。对不起，肚子哪儿疼不疼？对不起，对不起，对不起。
故意的，
我不是故意的，对不起。
是的，是的，我一定配合老师工作。谢谢老师关心。
小小妈妈客气了，明天我可以去家里看看小小。
哎，不用不用不用，小小真的好多了。明天我就把他送去学校。
嗯，那好，那就明天见。
哎，好好好。
要去旅行吗？
啊，对。
这箱子不装得下一个人了。嗯，
谢谢。
你哪儿有大姨？你把你男人怎么了？他今天可没出门，今天可是工作日。跟我好一次，我帮你。
我不知道你在说什么。
妈妈，别哭。
妈妈不哭，小小乖，妈妈会保护小小的。
小小也会保护妈妈的。
死人吗？不哭不叫哑巴了！
妈妈，
小小醒了，求你了，不要让孩子听到好吗？求你了啊！小小，快回去睡觉，我和妈妈玩呢。
妈妈不要玩，妈妈疼。
妈妈不疼，小小听话。快去！
贱人，敢推我，长本事了！啊！外边有男人了是吧？啊！有人给你撑腰了，让你的野男人来救你啊！来人呐！救命啊！快打死我！外边累死累活的赚钱养你，养这个家。家里有钱赚，有饭吃。看见客户，我都小人的三辈儿。
你呢？
哦，王姨有什么事吗？
啊，这不听邻居说，你们家最近又有情况了。
没事，都解决了。
有啥问题你可以来找我，居委会也可以帮你解决的。俗话说，远亲不如近邻嘛。你们家老公脾气不好，你就让着他一点。夫妻生活呀，就是这样的，你进一步，我退一步。再说了，男人在外边啊也不容易，我们在家里就要把家里的一切啊都要搞好。嗯，如果你需要的话，我们可以上门来调解，或者是今天 老公下班了，我们再过来一趟。
不用不用不用，真的不用。
小小妈，你也要为小小想想，孩子还小，为了孩子，你们也要搞好夫妻关系，对吧？
是是是，您说的对，我还有事，我先回家了啊。
哎哎哎，小小妈，哎呀，好心调解都听不进去，这种人，哎。
喂，妈。
欣欣，我给你们腌了一罐子酸菜。张坤上次说好吃，你没事了，今天回来拿。
我没有时间。
怎么了？又和张坤吵架了？
没吵架。
那就行。张坤就那性格，谁家夫妻不吵架？你看我和你爸吵了一辈子，现在不也挺好的？你就忍忍吧。
妈，你为什么总是让我忍？张坤在外面挣钱，难道我对这个家一点贡献都没有吗？从早到晚，我洗衣服、做饭、看孩子，365天，哪一天歇过？为什么还要让我忍？
你钥匙拿我这儿了，我来给你送钥匙。
野男人在家私会呢，说你个不要脸的东西，啊！你等着，我要告诉我儿子，让他收拾你，收拾你！
他再收拾不了我了。
你说什么？你说什么？
或许街头巷尾没有穿越时空的任意门，我也不能像迪士尼童话故事中那样拥有真正的魔法，但我希望某一刻某一天看到这些照片，可以穿越回忆与美好，又或是成长的记录。
Sometimes I wonder if I'm on the right thing.
所以，我们算什么？
好朋友。
我们一起去过的那些地方，一起度过的时间，你所谓那些对我的照顾和陪伴，都是你对朋友的状态。
我现在更想注重结果。先学会爱自己，再去爱别人。
哦，这是我朋友 Jordan， 我们学校的。
Hello。
他对你们 Art School 也有兴趣。
OK， 我刚好下课，可以带你们去逛逛。
好呀，走吧。
走吧，走吧。
小心。
哎，这里好酷啊！我能拍张照吗？
当然可以。
走吧。
这是我们平常上课的地方。都是 open space， 我们可以看到所有人的作品。
嗯，挺好。
不要碰，
没有素质。
不好意思，哎，就好奇一下嘛。
给人留点面子嘛。
好帅啊！他女朋友是这个吗？我怎么感觉我
是全角？
走吧。
嗯，啊，要走了，好，
嗯，
走吧。
哦，等一下，那个就是。我可以加一下你微信吗？就是可能有些时候要想找你拍照片什么的。
可以，你扫我吧。
哦，好呀。相机我用你的就好了呀。
OK， 那我们走吧。
走吧。
你平时喜欢看什么书呀？
武汉的笑话，童话书。你呢？
武汉的笑话，我其实不看书。
好吧。
哎，你看是什么书呀？
嗯，好像是讲关于梦境的童话书。嗯、你看它里面的插画都好漂亮，对吧？
嗯，我看看。如果我对你的爱就像是歌曲里面音符之间的空隙，你会将它们视若无物吗？
书写的挺好的。
这是什么？盗版旺仔吗？
这是正版的。
啊？
没吃过吗？
我还真没吃过呀。
看来我们不是一个时代的人。
你平时会养花吗？
很少吧。
为什么呀？刚才那些花不都挺漂亮的？
因为花开再美再艳，最后一天也会有凋落。
你等我一下。花虽然都会有落败的时候，但是我们总有办法去把它最好的一面保留下来。其实你摄影的意义也是这样子，虽然说就是照片里面的画面都不会重演，但是这一个个美好的瞬间都被你记录下来了，不是吗？
怎么我还被你教育了？摄影这件事情我不是比你更专业吗？
哎呀，我跟你在一起我也会进步的嘛。
好
吧，来吃个花送你，让你开心一点。
真的吗？
嗯。
好可爱。
是啊，真的。
这样他就能永远留在我的身边，永生花。
所以，你为什么这么喜欢拍照啊？
嗯，因为。所有说不出口的感受都藏在拍下的照片里。哎，你站过去一下。
走了。
先站过去吗？
我也曾和喜欢的人看过银河、星星、大海，只是我们的结局并没有像看过的美景那样美好。那时我才知道，我自以为短暂的浪漫，对别人而言可能比不过现实。但即便这样，当我走在路上看到幸福的 couple， 我还是会相信美好还是存在。而拍下这瞬间的我，也还会为他们的幸福而感到欣慰。只是我喜欢不代表我相信了。
快点收拾行李了，马上要赶不上飞机了。你怎么了，宝贝？
没事儿。
Sorry, boys.
Someone is on fire today.
Did you cheat?
Fuck!
I don't need to cheat to beat your ass.
What about me? You don't think you need to beat my ass too?
I need to take a pee first. Noah, switch a seat with me when I get back. I have to do something with this bullshit shit, you know.
What's wrong with you? You losing your mind? Trying to get us caught up?
Relax, man. What are you afraid of? Does a monkey suddenly know how to read?
Nah, man, we still gotta be cautious. No risk at an all-time high. Like, he always in our casino, and he know a lot of our guests. So if he know the truth and told them, we wouldn't make any money anymore.
All right, all right. What'd you say, the old-fashioned way?
You know what, man? I won for a reason. Brought this jade Buddhistapa from a master at a high price. You know, and he cast a spell on it. So, whoever's the owners, he blessed me every time.
Are you shitting me?
Nah, man. You need more winning proof? I've been taking your money all day.
Fair. You made your point.
I'm telling you, man, I done made hundreds of thousands of dollars this month. Okay.
Don't do anything stupid.
我真的保证在还你钱，但您能再借给我10万块，就10万块钱，就是。我给您2倍、3倍、
5倍，五倍的利息。
Why should I trust you?
我的命，
谢谢您，谢，太谢谢您，太谢谢您，
谢谢您，谢
谢，谢谢，谢谢，谢谢。
保佑你这种赌鬼！
能不能闭嘴啊！我操，连这佛祖一家也不行。今晚上那个很重要，我输了钱选他那里。
你能不能别他妈赌博了？欠了一屁股的债，家里一分钱都没有。
Stay at home. That is the order tonight from four state governors as the coronavirus pandemic spreads. New York, California, Illinois, and Connecticut all ordering non-essential employees to stay home. Those orders cover 75 million people across the United States. New York's governor today telling non-essential businesses in his state to reduce their workforce.
What's up, man? I'm just scared. Been seeing a lot of scary ass things on TV. That shit is killing people, man. Now we gotta work from home. I don't know what to do with my life. Let's see if I still got it or not. So, guys, since I lost my job and I don't have to work from home, I just want to show gamers out there how to play a few video games they don't know how to play. I know, many of you think that gaming is a waste of time, but trust me, it isn't. It's fun and it's gonna make you feel better. Stay with me, y'all. Don't go anywhere. Thank you all for those who are supporting me and donating their allowance to me. I love you all. I never thought such a day would come, but I'm glad I started gaming in the first place. Oh shoot, I died! No worries. We're going to finish this level no matter what. You gotta eat to survive. Stay home, eat, and play games. Because if that's what you're good at, then that's what you gotta do. Anyways, let's go back to playing now, shall we? Let's do this. Hey Ali, you've made my kids happy since you started playing those games. Thank you. Hey buddy, my girlfriend can be frustrating in this lockdown, but you keep me sane. Ali, you are a boss. I never knew someone out there could play so well. This is unbelievable. Guys, I'm glad the pandemic is over and everyone is going back to work. Some of us lost our jobs along the way, and I'm one of them. I won't be going back to work because game playing is now my job. And I'm happy doing it. It pays me more than 10 times than my previous job. I want y'all to stay safe out there and keep surviving. Now, let's continue playing because I know you're here to watch me play and not blabber. No, I just started playing and I'm dead already? This sucks!
My name is Pepe Pelaez. I am the co-director of my senior thesis. The production title is Train Heist. I am currently working on storyboards, but my role in the film is not only storyboarding, but I'm also an animator. And together with Bailey, we're working on overall other things like texturing, modeling, final lighting and editing.
My name is Bailey. I am basically doing all the artsier elements of the film, so the concept art and a lot of the modeling and some aspects of the 2D parts of the film as well.
So my name is Nanami. I'm the producer for this project. I joined this project because I had an interest in animation and, you know, the production of animation, and Pepe, knowing that, contacted me and asked me to come on board, and I gladly accepted.
I think it started when I was thinking about the next story that I was gonna do, and I knew that I wanted to do something that was energetic and kind of science fiction. So I started developing some characters, because with the constraints that you have to think about how many characters can you use and how long it can be. So I decided to have only a few characters in the beginning, and I sketched this notebook where I had a female character on top of a train with her like robot companion, and I decided to like start with that.
Well, I think from the beginning we always had this kind of idea that she was a little bit like of a leader, strong-minded and kind of stubborn in ways, but it kind of progressed even more, I would say, especially as we fleshed out the relationship she has with her brother now.
Or the first impression I got of Ada was that she was a very strong character, but there was also something internal that she needed to address.
So usually whenever I design any character, I like to do a lot of reference beforehand. So I'll think of films and other characters that currently exist in animated media or in real life that kind of give me a sense of who this character is, whether that's through different body shapes, personalities. So after gathering the reference footage, basically I take the stronger aspects and basically kind of merge them to make her, Ada. And basically whenever you're designing a character, at least for me, my process is doing a lot of exploration beforehand. So there's a lot of exploration of Ada that isn't anything what she looks like now. I kind of always knew I wanted her to be a little bit spunky, so I was keeping things like short hair, and because she's has some kind of emotional struggles that she's still going with, she's not as expressive as some of the other characters in the film, so things like how far her mouth can stretch when it moves and how wide her eyes go, when you're thinking about animation, those are important things. So it's thinking that she's kind of like, everything's tightly packed together. So even some of the shapes within her character, she has curves when you get into her actual body, but even her face is like practically a square. And I feel like it kind of, even if it's a little bit subconscious, it's going with how she's like stubborn, you know, sturdy, yeah. Well, I think she can be a pretty relatable character, because I think, at least for me, I think with like my experiences, and I think a lot of people can relate to this, there's always circumstances we have where we're a little bit stubborn or really stuck in our ways, and it takes almost like a certain circumstance or people to kind of make you to start thinking about things differently.
What I would want the audience to get out of this film is perhaps some reflection on their own life through understanding and going through Ada's experiences. I think we all have things that we've sacrificed and made decisions that we weren't unsure of, especially in a circumstance like right now where there's a lot of different choices we've had to make. So I think what I want people to feel after viewing this film is kind of a moment of reflection.
Be mindful, Ada. The pink mix can be very dangerous. Ada.
Brad?
Ada!
No!
Ada! 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 I can hear it.
I don't think you're ready for this.
No, Ada, wait. I can do this. Please.
Fine. But stay focused.
Yes!
All right. Let's do this. I see guards in front of me. Tap, initiate the breakdown. Tap, the power, shut it down. Tap! Nico? Nico!
Hey, big sis. Like the colors?
Dad.
Not bad.
Tap, Nico, I'm running to the back of the train. We need an escape.
Ada?
Nico!
Where's Dad?
I couldn't find him. That thing started shooting at me. Tap! No.
He's buying us time.
Tap, let's go. Tap.
Ada, we need to go now.
Dad's gone, and now Tap.
We'll find him. I'm sure of it. He's out there waiting for us.
Dicen que por las noches no más se le iba en puro llorar. Dicen que no comía, no más se le iba en puro tomar. Juran que el mismo cielo se estremecía al oír su llanto. Cómo sufría por ella, que hasta en su muerte la fue llamando. Sola con sus puertitas de par en par, juran que esa paloma no es otra cosa más que su alma, que todavía la espera a que regrese la desdichada. Las piedras jamás.
dreams stop. My dreams stop.
Became.